At the entrance to the Scottish Highlands stands a majestic fortress, Stirling, one of the finest castles in Europe. But it's surrounded by an ancient and mysterious landscape, which has shaped Scotland's destiny. Why is so much myth and history concentrated in this one place?
Every significant event in Scottish history for the last 2,000 years has either impacted or been impacted by Stirling.
Entering through the castle's mighty gatehouse is like traveling back in time to a golden age of knights and armor. Its huge medieval hall is the largest in all Scotland. But Stirling's true power lies underneath these buildings. They all stand on a mighty and immovable volcanic rock. Forged around 300 million years ago, it's a natural fortress. But what makes this rock the foundation stone of so many legends? And how many secrets are still locked inside it? At Stirling Castle in Scotland, a mysterious structure emerges from the valley below. It's called the King's Knot. Legend says that one of history's greatest treasures once stood right here. The Round Table of King Arthur and his knights. Is it possible that Stirling was founded hundreds of years earlier, at the dawn of the Middle Ages? Under the grass and soil of the King's Knot, investigations have detected a series of mysterious ditches. They could belong to an ancient ritual site that used to have a ring of standing stones at its center. But the knot also stands next door to what was once a jousting ground. Arthur and his knights were connected with jousting. So is this a coincidence or a clue to the origins of the Round Table story? Although jousting is associated with Arthur, Murray is convinced popular history has it wrong. Arthur would have been born too early to joust.
This is the classic European medieval jousting. You've got people in shining armor, there'll be fights, there'll be rivalry, all of which gets expressed on the field. Who will win, who will lose, blood's shed, you know, fair maidens swooning, all that sort of romantic stuff happened here.
Murray also suspects the King's Knot is just a garden from around the same time. But the jousting that went on next to it might explain the Arthur stories. The king who built the jousting ground was called James IV, one of Scotland's greatest rulers. James adored tournaments and the tales of King Arthur.
James IV, he reorganizes this landscape. He sets up the majesty, the pageantry of Stirling, the pageantry of the jousting ground, but it's his son who develops the very, very elaborate tournaments. He develops this King Arthur theme.
Murray thinks that this is a royal playground. Scottish kings held Arthurian-themed tournaments right here, called round tables.
Behind me is the King's Knot. It's actually built on a much older royal garden. And this is the garden that appears to be linked to the round table to King Arthur. So what we have is a very elaborate theatrical landscape.
Stirling Castle is a symbol of Scotland's freedom. A castle so powerful that Scottish kings invented a legendary past for it. But could the stories of King Arthur at Stirling somehow be true? The river below the castle has been a natural frontier since prehistoric times, and on the opposite hill stands a clue. This imposing tower is called the Wallace Monument. Built in modern times, It commemorates where William Wallace made his headquarters during the Battle for Stirling. But beneath it lies something far older. A ring of stone walls built by an ancient British tribe. These are the ramparts of a hill fort. A 260-foot bank, 10 feet wide, made of massive stones. Could this be a real-life Arthurian castle? Archaeologist Murray Cook tries to piece together the evidence. Murray's investigations suggest that these earth-covered stone ramparts are at least 1,300 years old.
This is an early medieval citadel. This is a place where an early medieval lord would impress people, would host people, would go out on hunting expeditions, would go out on warfare. The eaves of the hall would ring with song.
Far from being Camelot, Murray believes that the forts of the Arthurian age were settlements surrounded by stone circles. To make the walls strong, they layered earth and stone and reinforced them with timber beams.
This stone we got from an excavation downslope, but it comes from this rampart. This is a rampart destroyed by fire in the 6th and 7th centuries AD. This stone is from the collapse and the destruction of this rampart.
The fort dates to a time long before Scotland even existed, when Stirling was part of ancient Britain. In the violent chaos of the 6th century, one man is said to have stood out as a beacon of hope, Arthur.
Whoever King Arthur is, he is a war leader who is very successful at the end of the 5th century. Certainly, if Arthur exists, this is a sort of location, this is a sort of place that he would be familiar with.
Murray thinks the ancient stone reveals a society fighting for survival.
I think this is what we call vitrified stone. See here, I think we have three stones. One stone here, and then this in the middle that seems to have melted and fused these two together.
Murray thinks that when invaders attacked the fort, they set fire to the reinforced defenses. Locked inside the earth, the timber burned with such fierce heat, it melted the stone. The violent end of the fort under the Wallace Monument coincides with the very first mention of Arthur. A heroic poem written about the people here in the year 600.
For the people, Arthur becomes an important figure. Whether or not you really believe there was an Arthur, you're identifying yourself with a historic figure, with a figure that leads resistance.
It's an extraordinary final twist.
Wow. That's amazing.
Stirling may not be Camelot or Snowdon, but did the violent world around it create the Arthur myths?
The geography, the geology of Stirling for 2,000 years has been central to Scotland's destiny. This is the only place where armies can cross, all fighting, all dying to control this location, this Stirling, this place of strife.
Murray thinks this landscape shaped Scotland's identity.
Just as Arthur was 600-700 years before him, Wallace is this enormous heroic figure. So Wallace, in effect, becomes the inheritor of a tradition of resistance. History is reinvented by each successive generation.
Stirling's imposing architecture makes it one of the most important medieval castles in the world. Scotland, as we know it, might not exist without this towering fortress.